What's poppin', everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Suguru, and I'm a high school student passionate about programming and computer science. On this channel, I make tutorials on the projects that I've made in the past. If you're new to this channel, please smash the like button below and subscribe to my channel. Also, feel free to visit my website up here to watch other videos that I've made and read blogs that I've written. Please feel free to follow me on Instagram and add me on Discord if you're a programming enthusiast like me. Okay, let's start the video. Before I get started on the project, I wanted to mention that I'm looking on a different monitor, so if I'm not looking at the computer, that is why. And I have like two sheets of paper which I printed out for the project, so I might be looking on a paper or something. That's just why. Okay, so I'm just gonna start the slideshow here. So today we're making a modified version of the NIM game Beater in Python. So I'm just gonna say that I have a GitHub project for this. So if you're stuck somewhere, please take a look at that project. It has like unnecessary comments and all that, but I think you will get it. So before I explain what a NIM game is, I'm gonna explain the Python skills you will need for this specific project. So you will need a very basic understanding of using methods and classes. Like, you don't need to be like super familiar with classes, but some familiarity will help. Now, second, you must be able to use exceptions. This is because we're gonna handle a lot of input. And the third reason, the third skill is that you must be able to use strings. And like, suppose I'm going to use f strings, which the old way is dot format, I think. And also we will have to manage input, which is an input is a string, obviously. So now I will explain what the NIM game exactly is. So the game of NIM is a mathematical game said to be originated in China. So in the normal version, it's the game is played between two players and played with three heaps of any number of objects. So basically, each player removes any number of objects from one of the heaps, like every turn. So the objective for this game, how we win, is to make the other person remove the last number. So if we're playing by matchsticks, the person who removes the last matchstick loses. So this is like an example gameplay situation. So in this case, we have three matches in each pile, and we have two matches. So person A and B are playing against each other. So in the first turn, person A takes two matches. Now, B's turn. So B takes two matches from the second pile. Now, A is left with the last match. So A loses in this case. So basically, I claim that the project I'm making is a modified version. So the basic idea is the same. My modified version, A and B are counting up until 30. And they can count up to three numbers at a time. Whoever counts 30 loses the game. This is the game I was playing when I was really little, and I wanted to make something similar to this. So, a more generic way to explain this game is that, first of all, A and B are counting until X. X is a user input. They can count up to Y numbers at a time. Y is also a user input, and whoever counts X loses the game. So the initial approach or strategy towards writing code for this game is that for A to win the game when the max number is 30, meaning whoever counts 30 loses, to win this in this situation, A has to count 29 to win the game. So to make this happen, A has to take control of the game so A can always count 29, no matter what the situation is. So we must notice that when the current number is represented by N, no matter what player B counts up to. So in this situation, we have, there are three options, N plus 1, N plus 2, and N plus 3. Player A can bring the current number to N plus 4, no matter what player B chooses. So an example for this is when N equals 25, and it's player B's turn. Player B counts 26, which is N plus 1. And the second situation is when player B counts 26 to 27, 27 being N plus 2. Final situation is when player B counts 26, 27, and 28. 28 is N plus 3. So for each of these situations, for situation 1, player A can count 27, 28, 29, 29 being N plus 4. For the second situation, player A can count 28, 29, 29 being N plus 4. For the third situation, player A can just count 29, which is N plus 4. As you can see, no matter what player B chooses, player A can always end with a 29, which is an N plus 4. So, if we take control by always being able to land at N plus 4, there must be a set of numbers we should land to win. So, for the previous example, how do we find these sets, right? We know that one of the numbers in the sets must be 29, right? So, do we know which number this list of these sets of winning numbers will start at? No, we don't really know it, but we know the number we should land at to win, which is 29, right? So basically, this number is like the losing number, which is 30 minus 1, which is 29. So we can start by subtracting 4 from 29, which gives us 25, and subtract 4 from that again, which gives us 21, and so on and so forth, and we end up with a list looking like this. So if player A lands at any of the numbers at this list, in this list, no matter what move player B makes next, player A can always land on the next number of this list. So we just continue until player A counts 29 and wins the game. So now, let's just jump right into the coding process. So first, when we are programming this thing, we need inputs. So some of the inputs we might need for this program. So we need an integer reaching number. So this number expresses which number to count up to. In my previous example, I used the number 30 for this. So whoever says 30 loses the game. We also need a max increment. For the previous example, I used 3. So one could count 25, or one could count 25, 26, or 25, 26, 27. So the max increment was 3 in this case. So next, this might be a little optional, but I'm gonna add this in my program. It's whether the player or the computer goes first. So the player will manually input a number in the program, but the computer will just automatically generate the best number, the best move, right? So in this case, straight off the bat, we can notice that we must use exception handling to check whether the inputs are valid. So a valid input in this case will be an integer, right? So to just keep on asking the user for inputs when the inputs are valid, we can use a while loop to do this. So if an error pops up, just repeat the while loop, right? So then we can just keep on asking the user for inputs until the inputs are valid. Now, I've created a new file called main.py. I'm using Visual Studio Code for this project, but you can use whatever you want. I'm just looking at my paper. So first, we can print like something like a welcome message, right? So we can say, print, maybe you can go to the next line just to make things more readable. We can say, welcome to NIM game. So now we can just give a brief explanation, maybe. So we can say, you will count from 1 to the region number. Because this is what we're doing, essentially. Now, oh, actually, let's just add something. So we can just give some more explanation. Since the computer will perform the best possible moves to win, you can also use the program to beat your friend. I'm just gonna put this line, you know, just because the original one I made, I incorporated this, but later I thought it was kind of useless. But we can use this when, if you're playing this game against someone and you just want to beat them, then you can input their moves into this program so that the computer automatically generates the best move for you. So I'm just gonna right click that. Now, first, we're gonna run a while loop for this. So the basics of a while loop in this case is that we can create a Boolean value. So we're gonna call it not valid, just because, actually, yes, not valid equals the true. So in while, not valid. So this checks whether not valid is true or not. So while not valid. Now we're gonna put this in a try statement. I'm gonna explain why later. Just follow me on this. Print. Region number. So I'm just going to state a brief range for this game so that it won't be too crazy. So then we can ask for a number, right? Now I'm just going to call this reaching number string because the input is a string. So we can say input enter reaching number. So this will ask the user to enter a reaching number. Now, here we can say increment string equals to input enter max increment. So basically this asks like how many maximum numbers can we count at one time. In the previous example I used, this was 3. Now, we're just going to say reaching number equals 2 int reaching number string. So we're just going to try to int this thing. So the reason I use a try here is that when we try to int an integer string, suppose string 5, that will work when we try to int it. But if we say something like ABC, this won't work. This will pop up an error. So actually, I'm just gonna create the error here, accept value error. No, I'm just gonna pass this for now. Now, for my case, I'm gonna make it so that this category here, this if statement is a non-valid statement. So we can say something like not 20 smaller or equals to each number, or not, no. And we have to set the max, so 100, or not, what was it? Let's say 3, smaller or equals to increment, smaller or equal to 10. Now, since we're mentioning this, we can add a description here saying that print the max increment as b, or the increment as to be between 3 and 10. I'm just going to say inclusive. So, again, this range right here is to make sure that things don't really get too crazy. I don't really want to play with a great, like a super big number anyways. So, that this is for that purpose. Now, if it is a valid input, this has to be true, and we're putting it in a not, so it's going to be this whole thing is going to be false. If this is a valid increment, if this is valid, this will be true too, so this will be false. Not, this whole thing will be false. Now, false or false will result to false. But if either of them, either this or this bracket right here is true, that means either the reaching number is not valid or the increment value is not valid. So this, I can just comment and say not valid, right? Now, I'm just gonna pass this for now. So this is the valid one. Now, if this is not valid, if that is not valid, what can we do? Well, if it's not valid, we want to treat it like this value error, meaning this value error is just for this int process. Because if you try to int a string which contains like alphabets or letters, then it will cause a value error. So if it reaches here, that means there is no value error, but we want to treat it like a value error because it's not in the valid range. So therefore, we can actually manually raise the value error. So that is when, I keep on deleting that. So this is when it is not valid. Now we're gonna write the code for when it is valid. Now, first we can define a variable 0, play. Equals to compute, right? Actually, no, we don't. So now we are going to define some variables here. So goes first equals to input. Who goes first? 0. Meaning computer or 1, which is clip, right? And then we can just put something like this just to show that players are supposed to input there. Now, if, so here we specified either the input is going to be 0 or 1. If it's not, it's an invalid input. So we can just check that easily. If goes first in, we can say goes for first equal equal, but that's kind of tedious, so I'm just gonna make it, put it in one step. And, oops, sorry. 0, 1. This is when the response is either 0 or 1. So now we're gonna pass this, and we're gonna create an else variable, which obviously, in this case, the whole we can say that the whole while loop checking is invalid. So we can again raise a value error. Right. Actually, here I'm just gonna say print game is gonna start. I'm gonna obviously replace this later on, but I just want to show you that it works. Now for the value error, I also have to add an important part, which is not valid. You have to change this to false, because at this point, this is already valid. It passed all the checks, so not valid equals to false, and this loop is no longer going to run. So for value error, you can say print enter a valid man or integer, and obviously not valid will equal to true, just to keep it true, right? Now let's just try and run this thing. I think it should work properly. So here, we're going to enter a reaching number between 20 and 100. So let's just say enter 30. We can enter 3 here. Now we can just say 0. Now here, as it shows here, this program is working well. Now let's try something else. So we're going to enter, ABC. Now we can just enter 3. So as you can see here, it says enter a valid command or integer. So it did the int part, and now it raised a value error. So now it is showing this because a value error occurred, right? So now we have to do it again. Now let's do it correctly. 40. We can do 3. Now here, if I don't put 0 or 1, it will again print this message because I raised the value error if it is not 0 or 1 right here. So now we have to actually redo the whole process, but as you can see, it works if all the values entered are valid. Now that we know that this whole while loop thing works, we printed here that the game is going to start. Obviously, now it is time to replace this. So I'm going to go up here, and I'm going to define a class. Now, usually classes are used to make objects, so like multiple objects. But in this case, I'm just making a class so that it's easier to manage methods, and it's also easier to use different variables in the same class using self. So that is the purpose of me using a class here. So I'm just going to call it main game. So we need init method. Now, we are from here, from this while loop, when, so we're going to replace this and we're going to pass all the information we got during this process to this function here. So what information can we get? Well, we have to get the reaching number. We have to get the increment. And we have to get goes first. Right? I know these variable names are the same, but this is just a parameter name, so it doesn't really matter, just if you're wondering. So now we have to initialize it, self.reaching number equals to reaching number, self.increment, increment equals increment, self.goesFirst equals to goesFirst. Now that we've initialized the basic variables, I wanted to go over strategies of adding more methods to this class. So we have just created an init class, and we're going to create a goToPlayerTurn method. So obviously the player types in the input, and the computer automatically chooses the best move. So one thing to note here is that we have to separate the methods of the player and the computer. The program must recognize whether the computer is going first or the player is going first. The difference is basically, if the player is going, we have to ask for an input, but if the computer is going, then it just automatically chooses the best move, and it just has to print the total and what it chose, basically. So now, this is the basic initialization here. So now we have to store the total variable. We have to store the total value. When I say total value, I mean, like, if I say 1, 2, and 3, 3 is my current total value. If I say 4, 5, then 5 is my total value. So I can say self.total equals to 0, because we're starting at 0, and then we go like 1, 2, 3, right? Okay, so that was the total variable. Now we're creating a self.current choice goes to 0. So basically, the difference between these two is that the total just keeps on adding up the value, and like the current choice is like a more updated version of the total value. Now we have to create an ending win number. So I'm just going to create a new win number, and I'm going to call that self.endingWinNumber equals to, so basically this is like 29 in the previous example. It is the number we must land to win, ultimately win. So this is pretty easy to find. We can just say self.reachingNumber minus 1, because that is the way we find the ending number, right? So the next thing we have to do is we have to make a winning increment. So last time we could go up by 1, 1, 2, or 1, 2, 3, meaning the max increment was 3. But to take control of the whole game, we have to go by 4s, right? So if we go by 4s, no matter what the other player chooses, we can always take control of the game and land on specific numbers. So I'm just going to show you quickly what I mean by that. So I just came back to this slide here. So as you can see, we can always bring it back to n plus 4. And the relationship is always the same as long as this constant 4 is 1 larger than the max increment, which is 3 in this case, 3 numbers at a time. So we have to add 1 to that max increment to get this constant, right? So this, so also this number set here, the winning number set, it all increments by 4 because we can always know that the numbers can land on these numbers. So this is an increment by 4, which is 3 plus 1. So I hope that helps understanding that part. So I'm just gonna name this follow increment equals to self dot increment plus 1. Now, we are going to create this when list. So the numbers the computer should land on to make the best possible move. So to do this first, I'm going to make an empty list. So self when number list. Oops, not lost. It's an empty list. Now, we're gonna run a for loop to try to append all the numbers in the list. So as you can see in this slide, 29 is the ultimate winning number. But we have to make sure we can land on these numbers first to be absolutely certain that we can land on 29. And as I said, these numbers increment by 4. So I wanna make an exact list like this. So we need some algorithms for this. So basic for loop. What we can do here is we can say I in range. In range self dot ending number, ending win number. Number 0, negative 1 times self dot follow increment. So, okay, so what this loop does here is that it starts at the ending win number, right? So in this example right here, the ending win number is 29. And then it goes up to 1. 1 is not included, so it ends at, it goes up to 1 and 0 is not counted. So this is the increment of a for loop. Now, we are starting at the win number, meaning the max number minus 1. So we have to decrease all the time. So that is what the negative 1 is for. And we have to decrease by the follow increment, right? So in this example, the follow increment is 4, right? Because this goes up by 4 and decreases by 4. So to stay on track on this list, right? So then that is for this. We're going to decrease by 4 all the time, and we are going to append whatever I comes out. So this way we can make a list similar to this. It's just in like reverse order, but that doesn't really matter, and I'm going to show you why. It's the important part is that we have to be able to make a list with which contains all the winning numbers that we have to land on. And we have a solution for that, which is self.winNumberList equals to sorted. Self.winNumberList. Just because I just told you that this is in reverse order, but if we use, if we sort it out, we can get it in exactly ascending order, so that is helpful. Now that we have worked on the init method, I'm gonna make a new method, which I explained previously. Go to player turn, which contains self. And so the purpose of this method is to check this goes, no, self.goes first. And if you remember, if self-talk goes first is 0, then the computer goes first, right? And if it is 1, the player goes first. So the purpose of this method is to figure out which goes first and call the appropriate function for that to happen. So quickly, this is a short function. If self.goes first goes to 0. Remember that I didn't convert this to an integer, so it's still in string form. We're gonna make a new method called noInputCharacter. And we're gonna be specific, I guess. Self.goes first equals to 1. Then we're gonna go self.inputCharacter. Oops. So when it is 0, the computer goes first, meaning it is a computer which is a character or player which doesn't require an input. On the other hand, if the user selected 1, that would be a player, so that would require an input. So it's an input character. So that is what this go to player turn method does. So let me just quickly change this part here, where it says game is going to start. So what we want to do is we want to create a variable, an object actually, main game object, and it is going to have reaching number, so we can say reaching number, and increment is the increment. And goes first is obviously goes first. And then the first time we call it, we want to call this go to player turn method. So we're gonna do that game.go to player turn method, right? Now that we have created the go to player turn method, I'm gonna introduce you to the self no input character method. this is a method where the computer generates the best possible number. So we are obviously going to use the self.win number list that we have created in the init method, and the computer will take a move that lands on one of the numbers in the list. If the player is using the winning strategy, meaning if the player actually knows the increment strategy, we can't actually do it. Because the player is going to be landing on those winning numbers, and we can't move by increment plus 1. So if the player already knows the winning strategy, there's really no way for the computer to win. So if that is the case, just for the sake of this game, I guess the computer can just pick a random number between 1 and the max increment, just so it's just playing along, right? So. But we have to make sure that every turn the computer checks whether the player is still following the winning strategy or not. So, oops, the moment the player stops using the winning strategy and stops landing on those winning numbers, the computer is just gonna go right it back in and start landing on those winning numbers so that it can stay on track. It can just get on track of winning again. So at the end of the self.noInput method, obviously we would have to lead to the next method, which is the self.inputCharacter method. It's just like, it just goes from computer, player. So that is what I mean. And we must always check whether the self.total, meaning, yes, the self.total is larger or equal to the self.reaching number, yeah. So, so if the total is basically equal to the self.reaching number, meaning 30, in the previous example, we have to end the game and announce the loser, right? So now let's start making the known but character method. We can go define and stop, no input character. Wow, kite auto completion. Just very good. And then we can say print. So we can say the computer's turn, right? Computer's turn. Oops. Let me use double quotations for this. Computer turn. Now we want to print out the current total just to show the player. So we can say here's where we're going to use F strings. So first we have to not indent. Go to the next line and say current total. And this is like the F-sharp thing, F-quote thing, where we go self.total, and it just pops up like dot .format, basically. Now, the next thing we have to do is to check whether the player is following the winning strategy or not. Because depending on that, the computer can either just follow the winning strategy, or if it has no hope, it has to pick a random number. So let's say self dot total not in self dot win number list. So if self dot total not in self.win number list. So this is when the player is not following the winning method. Because as I mentioned back here, the winning method is basically following these numbers and landing on them. So if the player, like the actual input player, has landed on one of those numbers, meaning the total is equal to one of these numbers, that means the player is basically following the winning strategy. So the computer can't really do anything at this point. So if this is the case, that this means player is following winning strategy. If this is the case, you can say no. So in this case, it says self.total is not in the number list, meaning the player is not following the winning strategy. So we can say input player not following winning strategy. Right? Now we can create a for loop that loops through all the items in self.win number list. I will explain what I did later. So we can say for I in self.win number list. We can say if I is larger than self.total and I minus self.total is smaller or equal to self.increment, then we can say self.current choice equals to I minus self.total. I'm going to explain why I wrote that for loop in the first place. So this is an example scenario of generating the best number. So here we're the last person to count 10 loses the game. Now the max increment is 3. Now, we can generate the winning number list based on the information given. So we know that the person who can land on 9 wins the game. And as I mentioned before, 3 plus 1 is 4. So we can just decrease by 4 all the time. And we know that 1 5, and 9 are the winning numbers, meaning we have to land on these numbers in order to land at 9 and always win the game. So, let's for an example, player B's current position is 3. Let's say it's 3, right? Now, to get on track to reach 9, as I mentioned, we have to land on one of those winning numbers, 1, 5, or 9. So, the best step to take here is to move up to 5, right? To add 2 and move up to 5. So, we know that. But the thing is, the computer has to decide this. So, what logical steps do we take to reach the conclusion that, well, we have to land at 5, right? From 3 to 5. So, first, to select which number to land on, which can also be said in terms of the program which we were writing, which is self.total, our new self.total, the number which we are landing must be bigger than the current total value. Well, this is kind of pretty easy to understand because we can't go from 3 to 1, right? We can only go to numbers larger than 3 because we can never go back. So that is what this statement is saying. So now we have two numbers we can land on, 5 and 9, based only on this condition, because 1 is eliminated due to the previous condition because 1 is smaller than 3 and we cannot go back, right? Now, the only realistic way to move is to move to 5, right? We cannot move to 9. Well, why is that? Well, this is also pretty logical too. This is because the difference between the number which we're landing, 5 or 9, and the current self.total must be less than the max increment. So, if we're landing at 5, the max 5 minus 3 is 2, the max increment is 3, so that is smaller, so that is good. But if we're landing at 9, 9 minus 3 is 6, max increment is 3, and so that will not be acceptable. So basically, yeah, the reason we cannot jump to 9 is because 9 minus 3 is 6, which is larger than the max increment 3. So basically, we cannot move any more than 3, right? We can go 4, or we can go 4, 5, oops, sorry. We can go 4, we can go 4, 5, or we can go 4, 5, 6. But we cannot go larger than that. That eliminates the possibility of 9. So this is the logical step of reaching to the conclusion that, well, to make the best move possible, we have to get to 5, right? Now let's get into the actual code we have written, this for loop right here, and explain why this is based on the idea I explained before. So, first we said that the number to land on must be bigger than the current total value, right? So, in this program right here, the current total value is stored as self.total. So, since I is the number, is every number in the loop, which we can say is 1 or 5 or 9, it loops through all of them. So this number has to be greater than self.total. If we go back to this example, the I, which can correspond to 5, must be greater than 3. If I is 1, which it will be because we're looping, it is not greater than 3. So it will fail on this condition. So that is the first condition which we are testing. The second condition, as I mentioned, is that the difference between the number which we are landing and the current self.total must be less than the max increment. So how do we find the difference? Well, The number which we are landing, as I said, can be expressed as I, because I is basically 1, 5, and 9, right? Going through the loop. So that minus the current self.total. So in this program, we can say it's I minus self.total must be smaller or equal to self.increment, because we can move 3 steps. So we are including 3 steps, or we can move 1 or 2 or 3, 1 or 2 or 3 steps, right? So I minus self.total is the difference between the landing number and the current self.total number, which has to be smaller or equal to the self.increment, right? As explained here. So if that is the case, self.currentChoice equals to I minus self.total. Now, I think I've put a text message where I explained this self.currentChoice. So as I said, self.currentChoice is just the increase. For example, if you're moving from 3 to 5, then self.currentChoice is basically plus 2, because we're moving 2 steps, right? So if that is the case, obviously self.currentChoice will be 5 minus 3 equals to 2, because we're moving 2 steps. So here we're assigning self.currentChoice, which is plus 2, to this I, which is 5 in this case, and the self.total, which is 3 in this case. I hope that makes sense. Now, we can, at this point, we can say, we can print this information. We can print the self.currentChoice saying that, well, the computer chooses this number, right? To this number, to count this many numbers forward, right? So now we can say the computer chooses. Now here I'm sure F strings take place, self.currentChoice. And then just to make things readable, we can add go to next line symbol here. Now obviously we have to add self.currentChoice to self.total and update self.total. I wrote this as this, but it's a mistake, sorry. It should be self.currentChoice. I wanted to quickly mention that I made a typo here, chooses, and this print statement should be outside the for loop, like this, so that it doesn't print every single time the for loop is executed. Because here, if the player is using the winning strategy, there's nothing the computer can actually do, because the computer cannot move to the next winning number, because we can only move 3 steps in this example, right? So there's nothing the computer can really do. So for the sake of this game, I mentioned that we can pick a random number between 1 and the max increment and just make the computer choose that number. Well, I think many of you know this at this point, but first we have to import random. Here we can say elif self.total in self.win number list. So this basically means the current total where the user picks is either 1, 5, or 9. Basically, he knows the strategy and he's following the numbers which we have to follow to win this game, right? So this is when player input player is following winning strategy. I can type now. Here, we have to manually pick it by using the random module. So we can say self.currentChoice. So self.currentChoice is just like how many steps we're going further, right? Either one or two or three or whatever it is, up to the self.max increment. So we can say goes to random. Oops. And then dot rank int. So this random dot rand int function, if you read the description, it says return random integer in range A, B, including both endpoints. So if it includes both endpoints, obviously we have to start with one, and we can go up to self.max. Oops. Self.increment. Okay. Now, here we can say that we can just report it, just like we reported it here. We can report. We can report the computer chooses self.currentChoice. And we can add a go to next line sign symbol here. Now we obviously have to update the self.total value. So we can say self.total plus equals to self.currentChoice. Now this final step is to check whether the game is over or not, meaning whether we have reached the number or not. So here we can say if self.total is larger or equal to self.reaching number. So as I mentioned, self.reaching number is the number in which the game ends. So in my previous examples, I used 30 many times, and self.total just stores the current total value. Right? So if it is larger or equal, meaning if it has gone to 30, 31, 32, or anything above that, this will apply. Here we can just mention game over, basically. Right? And then here we can say, in this case, the computer is lost, right? So we can say print the computer. Computer reached self.reaching number, and the next line we can say print the computer loses because the computer reached the number like the number 30, and then it loses, right? So we can just say the computer loses. And obviously we have to include an else statement, which is when the game is still going. So if the reaching number is 30 and we're still at 15, we have to keep on playing, right? So if that is the case, we're gonna go to self.input character. So this method I haven't yet made. I will make it soon. But basically, as I mentioned before, this is the computer's move. Everything is chosen based on, well, best practices and in some cases randomness. But after we finish, after the computer finishes making its move, we have to move to the input character, which is the actual player, which has to input whatever move he or she wants to make. Now let's get into the last step, which is creating a self.input character method. So as I mentioned, in this method we will ask for an input from the user. So while the input is small or is invalid, we will use a while loop and an exception handling to keep on asking the user for the input. It is like the same thing which we did in the beginning of this program. So this again leads to the self.noInput character because it goes computer player, and as I did in the noInput character method, we also have to check whether self.total is larger or equal to self.reaching number, meaning we're checking if the game is over or not. So we have created the self.noInput character method. So now we are going to add our new method below this. You can say def input vector and it contains self. Now, when input player's turn, right? Player's turn. Now, as I mentioned, we have to use while loop and exception handling in this case. So we can say not valid equals true. No. Equals true. And we can say while not valid. Print. If I can type today. Your return. And we can say, we can let the player know what the current total is, because that might be important when the player's trying to make their next move. So, print f backslash n. So we can say current total is, well, it's just self.total, right? And then we can ask the player to pick an increment. Pick the increment. And we can just let them know that the max is self.increment, right? Next, we can ask for the input. So we can say current choice equals the input you choose. So this is where the player is going to input whatever value they want to move. So now we have to use exception handling right here. As I mentioned in this example, if you're trying to int like an alphabet or a letter, it will produce a value error. So we have to understand that. So we can say self.currentChoice equals to int self.currentChoice. Now, sometimes this might produce an error. So we can say accept value error. I'm just going to pass this for now. Next, we just have to check whether the increment is within the proper range, meaning if not, not one smaller or equal to self.currentChoice, smaller or equal to self.increment. And you can say raise value error. So if this is when the input is invalid, because if it is valid, this has to be true. No, if it is valid, this has to be true, because the current choice, meaning oh, I want to count two up, like two forward, like 2, 3, or 3 forward, like 2, 3, 4. If that is the case, self.currentChoice must be 1 or above, and equal to or smaller than self.increment. Oops. So if self.increment is, for example, 3, Self-talk current choice can be either 1, 2, or 3. You can go 25, 25, 26, or 25, 26, 27. This is what it's saying. And I put a not statement here, meaning if this is all false, then this if statement will run. And as I mentioned, this if statement is for when the input is invalid, so it will raise a value error and will bring it to this step. Now we can say else. This is valid input. You can say self.total plus equals to dot current choice. We can do this because if we have reached this point, self.current choice is already an integer, so we can just add it up to the total. And then obviously we want to break from the loop afterwards, so we can say not valid equals false. Now that we have completed that, since we have to check whether self.total is larger or equal to self.reaching number, we're going to do that here. So you might ask why I'm going to do that in this specific else statement. Well, this is because we don't want, we don't want to check if it's larger or smaller if we get a value error. So we cannot check it here. We cannot check if larger here. The reason being, if we get a value error, it doesn't matter if it's smaller or equal to. We have to redo the step. So we cannot check if it's smaller or larger, because if it's supposed smaller, it's just going to automatically bring us to the computer, and we don't computer string, and we don't want that. We want to make sure we keep on going. So the only time when we really have to check if the total is larger or equal to the self.reaching number is when all the inputs are valid and there's something added to the total. So basically we don't want to check it if we get a value error, because the user has to keep on going instead of bringing it to the no input character, meaning computer string. So that is the reason why I'm going to put the if statement in this specific else block. So we're going to go if self.total larger or equal to self.reaching number. You can say print you reached. We reached self.reaching number, and you can say you use. Okay, and obviously if this is not the case, the game's still going on, so we can just move on to self.no input character. Now, at this point, I think game, this program is done here, so I'm going to do some demos. Now, before I do the demos, I just want to mention, please make the changes I said to make. Like, for example, the self.total, I explained why I made a mistake previously. Please make those changes, or else this program's not going to work. So I'm going to go into the demos and show how this thing works. So the first example is the classic reaching number 30, max increment 3. I've been using this example throughout this whole tutorial. So first, the final reaching number is 29. So we can just, we get that because 30 minus 1 is 29. And we're going to go down by 4 each time because 3 plus 1 is 4. So we can say 29 minus 4 is 25, minus 4 is 21, and we can go 17, 13, 9, 5, 1. And this is just a reordered version of this. So first we can try that. So we're gonna go 30, max increment is 3, and let's just see whether the computer recognizes the correct numbers to land on so we can let the computer go first. So obviously first the current total is 0 and the computer chooses 1. So that's good because 1 is on the list, in the list. So I can choose 2. Now, then the computer chooses 2 and the current total is 5. So the computer landed on 5. So it's good, it's following the steps, right? If I say, and now if I put like an invalid input, like 5, it says, enter valid command or integer, meaning it caught the value error. Yeah, it caught the value error here, right? Because this statement, it caught it here. So now I had to redo it again because it brought us here, not valid equals to true, and it had to run through the loop again. Right? I can try it one more time if I say like A, it's not valid command or integer, so I have to try again. So now I can put something like 2. Obviously it adds up to 7. Now the computer chooses 2 and the current total is 9. Current total is 9, so the computer's doing good. It's following the winning number list and it's landing on the correct numbers. So we can say 3, computer chooses 1, 13. Now I'm just gonna keep on going. 4, invalid command or integer, 2, 17, 1, chooses 3, 21, and if we go 3, chooses 1, and we get to 25. If I choose 1, it chooses 3, it reaches to 29, and now I have no choice, right? So either I can put 1, or I can put 3 or 2, it doesn't really matter, because here I said if it's, we're checking if it's larger or equal to. It doesn't necessarily have to be 30, it can be 31, 32. This is the reason why I put larger or equal to, not just equal to, because if I say 3, it adds up to 32, but we already reached 30, so it loses because it recognizes it here. So that is how this thing works. Now, another demo is when I already know the strategy. So if the player already knows the strategy, I'm going to start. It's my turn, the current total is 0. Now, I know the strategy, and I know the numbers I have to land at, right? Which is 1. Now, the computer can't really do anything, because it can't land on 5, because it can only land on either 2, 3, or 4. It cannot land at 5. So, this is where this, if self.total in self.win number list, this is when the player is following the winning strategy. We are choosing a random integer between 1 and self.increment. They're both included. So this is what it did. It chose a random number between 1 and 3, which happened to be 2. Now I'm gonna continue following the strategy, and so the current total is 3, so we have to choose 2 to get to 5. Right. Now it again chose 3 randomly. I'm going to try to get to 13 next. My mistake. 9, so I can choose 1. And I'm going to get to 13 next, so I can choose 2. 17. I can choose 3. 21. So 1. 25. 3, and finally 29, so 3. Now the computer randomly chose 2, but it went over 30, it has already reached 30, so now the computer loses. So this is how it works. Basically, you can't beat this thing, so the only way you can beat the computer is when you go first, and you know the winning strategy, and you just follow it throughout the whole game. That's the only case where you can beat this program. Or otherwise, if the computer goes first, it can make whatever move you want, and you cannot escape the computer's winning strategy. So you just end up losing, if that makes sense. Now, just for the sake of thoroughness, I'm going to do another demo in which the reaching number is 40, max increment is 4. So in this case, we're going to create the win number list. Obviously, the computer automatically generates this win number list using the for loop I explained before. Well, we can do this manually. 40 minus 1 is 39. Since the max increment is 4, we add 1, we got 5. So minus 5 is 34, minus 5 is 29. So we go 24, 19, 14, 9, and 4. And the reordered version is this. Now, let's try and see if the computer follows this pattern. Let's run this. Now, reaching number is 40. Max increment is 4. And let's let the computer go and let's let it win. So first the computer chooses 4. Good job. It lands on 4. Now if I choose something like 1, the computer chooses 4. So the computer chose to land at 9, which is obviously in this list 2. Now again, I can do something like 8, which is larger than the max increment. Now it's going to say invalid command or integer. It's going to keep the total, and I have to go again, right? So now if I do something like 4, I would go to 13. Computer chooses 1. Total is 14. Very good. It stays on track. Now I can do like something like 3, 19, 1. Computer gets to 24, 2. Chooses 3, computer gets 29, very good, it's working properly. I choose something like 3, computer gets 34 right here, and I choose something like 1, chooses 4, 39, got here, and now it's my turn. Oops, sorry, it's my bad, sorry. So now, basically, whatever I choose, I can choose 1, 2, 3, or 4, but in anyways, I reach 40, so I lose, basically, right? So this is the program we made today. I hope you found that interesting, and I hope you learned something from that. So thank you so much for watching this video. As I mentioned in the beginning, I have my own website where I post blogs and other content, where I post my videos. So please subscribe to my channel. I only put my Instagram, but my Discord's mentioned in the beginning. So please check that out and add me if you're interested in programming like me. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.